right. Adjustments on the website. Cool. Hey, everybody. It's Emil. And Chris asked me to put together a blog post today. And, you know, I wanted to do something a little bit different than I see happening right now, you know, across the board, industry-wide. And there are some things that, for a lot of us, you know, they're starting out that need to really be focused on in a certain step-by-step manner. One of those things being obviously, you know, your technical abilities as a fitness professional, knowing what you know about, you know, fitness itself, technically, whether it be athletic training, you're working with special populations, seniors, the Silver Sneakers crowd. If you're working, for example, like myself with the bikini girls and the fat loss, the competitive levels of fat loss, there is, you know, definitely a need to have that mastered. And the sooner you master that, the better. And of course, you know, making sure that you're getting a lot of testimonials, before and afters that are legitimate testimonials. But you want to start doing all of these things from the front end. So whether you're in this for the first year and you're still in a big box gym, these are the things that I would really recommend. I didn't do these things myself when I first started. We didn't have the tools and resources, or at least the people that could help guide us to do these things. The next thing that I would see as the most important element is, again, you know, understanding the marketing aspect and the sales aspect. Two really vital components for a fitness professional to, one, get customers into your funnel, so to speak, so that they know that you are the go-to person based on those technical skills that I just talked about first. Then you bring the people in with your marketing, and of course, once they're sitting in front of you and you've had an opportunity to create scripts and you've created outbound videos and you have a great website and the Google placement is really great organically and you're not having to spend a lot of money. As we've all learned recently, a lot of that's also changing. These things that I just spoke about, you know, the marketing and the sales, and a lot of the strategy and techniques really represent a lot of what I refer to and what we call silver bullet, the magic dust. And I think that with too much emphasis on those things, there can be, you know, an overwhelming feeling that you're not quite doing enough of it. So you have to manage your time. One, you know, I use a variety of different tools to manage my time, which we can talk about, but that's not necessarily what I want to mention right now. The big thing is the aspect of the understanding of human nature. You want to look at this USP that we talk about right now as far as unique selling position, to separate yourself basically from the herd. You know, everybody has a boot camp. Everybody can basically, you know, teach some level of nutrition and help people lose weight. Everybody has yoga, everybody has Pilates, everybody has CrossFit. Everybody can pretty much go and study whatever they want as far as those technical abilities. But the big thing that I, you know, saw initially when I started 20 years ago is that I, you know, personally had a lot of stuff going on in my life, and it really seemed to interfere with my ability to do my job. You know, I was competent as a trainer, I knew how to do all of those things, but I wasn't able to kind of take those private segments of my life and separate them from what needed to be done professionally. And sometimes there was an overlapping, and sometimes it overlapped so much that it kind of derailed the whole program. I mean, to the point where the business was just sideways for a minute until I got myself straightened out. Now, a lot of customers that come in to see us right now have this big plan. They have, you know, been around the block a dozen times. They've had trainers before. They've done all the programs. They've had the diets, so on and so forth. But they're still stuck. And one of the things that I recently had another, you know, colleague and I, we discussed was we have to initially, you know, go through the pre-qualification process to find out what that person wants. But we also need to really look at, well, what's the number one, two, three cause that's stopping them from attaining these things? And a lot of times when they refer to it as peeling the onion and getting down to the most painful area that a customer might have and why they're doing this in the first place. So yeah, that's the why that they're doing it. But we've got to kind of figure out what the cause of getting to that place was in the first place. A lot of times people aren't able to identify what's creating the big blood loss in their life, you know, the energy drain. And we have to, you know, apply some tourniquets, put some brakes on, or at least release the brakes from those areas that are causing them the inability to move forward. You know, you can have the great gym, the great diet, the great trainer, and all of these things, you know, wanting to move forward with this goal, but you've got these other anchors that are slowing you down from achieving success. And it could be you as a fitness professional. It could be also, and the majority of the time, it's the customer. So here they come into the schedule, and you have a series of the typical questions to ask them to pre-qualify them, but they still can't seem to make any progress. They get the diet in place, they get the workouts in place, they get maybe the additional cardio and yoga and whatever else in place, but they just don't seem to be moving forward. Something is wrong. And I mean, you're doing all the right things, you're saying all the great stuff, you're getting in the face, you're pulling back, you're modeling and mirroring and doing all these fancy techniques, and at the end of the day, they're still dealing with something up here. It could be something in their career, it could be something that's going on with a spouse, it could be issues with money, it could be a lot of challenges. So you have to really dig in and find out what that is. Now, you know, this strategy works really well to get them to sign the check and to get into training with you, but it doesn't really do great at keeping them. You have to learn some skill sets that are going to allow you to be able to talk to these people in a way that they're going to understand that you are an ally, that you are there to help them. Now, this is a really, really difficult task to teach every single person on your team. So you as the leader in your company are probably going to be that person that's going to do this. And there's going to need to be some soft skill development. And this is what I refer to helping people understand what they don't know about what they don't know that's causing them to stop them from succeeding. Now, I recommend a lot of different books to people. One of them by the name of Daniel Goleman's Emotional Intelligence, Viktor Frankl's Man's Search for Meaning, Maxwell Maltz and the Rewrite with Dan Kennedy, Psycho-Cybernetics. These are three good resources. Now, for you to read these books, you could probably get them done in a week, you know, and go through book after book after book. And that's one aspect that you're going to be able to acquire the information that I'm talking about. But some of you that are 20 and just now starting, you're going to probably need to go through the life experience in order for you to understand the life experience that a customer or client is going through. If you've never lost your house, if you've never gone through divorce, if you've never had, you know, a situation where someone had you on the sidewalk with a shotgun pointed at the back of your head, you've never been in a war, you've never been, you know, in the military or in certain circumstances. I mean, I could go on and list a lot of things that some of the people that really know who I am and what my life story is, they understand. So when people come to me, I can really talk to them about a lot of stuff. And I can really help them understand how to unplug, unbreak, stop this, move this around, and get themselves to a certain place. These are skill sets that can be taught, but more importantly, they have to be learned. They have to be experienced. And I don't want a lot of you junior professionals, and I don't mean any disrespect by junior, but meaning, you know, you could be my age and just left corporate America and have been only training clients for the last year. Or you could be 20 and just, you know, getting certified. You're going to have to go through the experiences. So trust me, you can get the magic bullet formula, the marketing, the sales, and all of these things together, but you're going to need to have some life experience. And you're going to have to work with some coaches that have some life experience as well. You cannot read this in a book. No way. Okay? I'm telling you right now, you can have a PhD in psychology, but if you haven't been the person that's gone through any of those scenarios that I just mentioned, you're probably not going to be able to really advise people in a way that they're going to understand that what you've gone through, the heartache that you've gone through, you can teach them through those situations. And I'm not using that as an excuse. Those aren't excuses. Those are actually learning tools that I apply with customers and clients now. That's why when you deal with a great deal of customers in a variety, whether it be our bikini girls or competitive bikini girls that are, you know, winning title after title or on the covers of magazines, or you're dealing with a CEO or a brand new mom who's dealing with issues at home with her husband and they just lost their house and they've got babies to feed and so on and so forth. You've got to look at a lot of these different scenarios. Again, we'll get the books, read the books. Get the coaches, get the mentors, get the guys and the girls that have, you know, raised their hand and say, hey, I'm a guru, I can teach you. But I'm gonna also suggest that you make sure that they've walked the walk, okay? Because there's a lot of people that are raising their hand, putting their sign up and saying that they're gonna be a coach. They don't have that life experience to teach you the things that you're gonna need to learn, okay? It's just my two cents. I really would appreciate some comments on this blog post about this. I think this is a really important time. Yes, the marketing is good. Yes, the sales are good. Yes, the continued study is good, and I'm going to encourage that as someone who's starting a coaching business as well. I think you definitely want to, you know, check the qualifications of the coaches that you work with. Some have walked the walk and are making millions. You want to talk about making money? Great. When you start making that money, but you go through a divorce or you lose your house, or a parent dies, your life is gonna change. Can you keep yourself on track? Can you keep yourself from getting derailed and then having your entire business and your team fall apart because you fell apart, okay? Get those books I suggested, read those books, and understand those books. If you have any questions, comments, post down below. Love to talk to you. I love this business, as anybody will tell you. I've been doing it. I mean, how tough could it be? I work with women all day. I love it. So that's all I'm going to say. Love you lots. Peace. Check the blog here. Thanks to my boy, Chris McCombs, Big Chris. And this is a blast, man. You know, welcome to the fitness professional career of choice. This is it, man. This is the way to go. All right? Peace.